This is how to use a rotovap, also known as a rotary evaporator. This is a device you would use if you want to boil off a liquid very quickly. It's usually used for organic solvents. So there are two ways in which you can boil a liquid. One, increase the temperature of the liquid, or two, decrease the ambient pressure. Because a liquid boils when vapor pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure. Rotovaps do both of those things at the same time so that your solvent evaporates very, very quickly. So in order to get this all turned on, the very first thing you need to do is make sure there's water in the water bath and turn on the heat. This model uses water, other models can use water or oil, but this is going to take a few minutes to heat up. You are also going to want to put something cold inside the inner container here. There's an outer container and an inner container. This, the way I'm using it, it's a mixture of acetone and dry ice, because that should be at a constant temperature of negative 78 degrees Celsius. So, there are a few other things that need to be turned on in this particular model. You need to turn on the ability to rotate, and you need to turn on the vacuum pump. So, at this point, you'd be ready to use this on multiple samples sequentially. But my sample is in a round bottom flask, and the joint at the top fits this. So I'm putting my sample here. It's friction fit, but we do not want to trust that it's going to stay here, so I'm actually adding a clamp. Don't let go until you're satisfied that it's going to stay there. And now there are four more things you need to do to actually get this started. One is lower the sample into the liquid such that the top levels of the liquids are somewhat equal to each other. Two, start the rotation. Then there are two valves here, and I need to change both of them. This valve is not connected to anything, so when it's open, it's allowing air from the room to go in. I want to close this so air from the room cannot go in. This valve is connected to my vacuum pump, so I want to turn this and open it to the vacuum pump so that I apply a vacuum. And at this point in time, my solvent is boiling off very quickly. And as it does so, the vapor that's formed is going into this container. And because of the fact that I have the inner tube that's cold, currently at negative 70 degrees Celsius, my solvent is condensing onto that inner tube and it's dripping down to the bottom to be stored in this round bottom flask. So this is just an easy place to clean later. But this literally only takes a minute or two for this particular size of sample and the solvent that I'm using. Once you're ready to take your sample off, do all of those things that I did to put it on, but in reverse. So I am no longer applying vacuum. I need to allow air from the room to get in to stop the vacuum. I need to stop the rotation and lift the sample up. Now, this is at a temperature that is cool enough to touch. Make sure you know what temperature it's at because you don't want to burn your hand when you're taking this off. But at this point, I can take my sample off. And my clip just flew. But as you can see, my sample is now dry. But at this point, another sample can be put on here immediately. This can be used over and over again. In order to turn this off, there are multiple things you need to do. You need to turn off the vacuum pump. You need to turn off power to the rotator. You need to turn off the hot water bath. And you need to clean out this round bottom flask. All of my solvent that boiled off ended up here. This needs to go into a waste container.